Secretary of State Hillary Clinton will work from home this week as she recovers from a concussion. The State Department said over the weekend that she fainted due to dehydration, may have been due to a stomach flu that she battled last week. Clinton is being monitored by her doctors. Well, it appears that President Obama has tapped Massachusetts Senator John Kerry as his next Secretary of State. A source says the president may make the announcement later this week. Kerry narrowly lost the presidency in 2004 to President George W. Bush. He is chairman of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. He's also a decorated veteran of the Vietnam War. And tomorrow, the State Department gets a look at a detailed report about the attack on the consulate in Benghazi, Libya. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton ordered this review. Members of Congress are scheduled to get the classified briefing on Wednesday. Clinton will not testify. She is recovering after a concussion from fainting due to dehydration.
All right, coming up next, some of the other major headlines this morning, including that health scare for Hillary Clinton.
You're watching World News Now.
And now to health concerns for outgoing Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. She has been battling a stomach virus that's led to some other complications. With more on this, here's ABC's David Curley.
Hillary Clinton is at home recovering from a concussion as well as a stomach virus. In fact, the two are related. The State Department says the secretary returned from her latest trip with a stomach bug. But early last week, Clinton became dehydrated and fainted at her home. She apparently hit her head because officials say she suffered a concussion. It's the second time in 8 years she has fainted because of a stomach bug. But she's generally healthy, as she told Barbara Walters recently, who asked about a possible presidential run in 2016.
Is your age a concern to you?
It really isn't. I am, thankfully, knock on wood, not only healthy, but have incredible stamina and energy.
But staying home this week means the secretary will not testify about the terrorist attack in Benghazi, Libya.
Look, I've said it, and I'll say it one more time. No one wants to find out what happened more than I do.
A State Department report on what led to the terrorist attack, the death of Ambassador Chris Stevens and three others, will come out in the next couple of days. Clinton was set to testify before both houses on Thursday. Now she will stay home and two deputies will fill in.
Secretary of State Hillary Clinton is still recovering at home today from the concussion she suffered last week after fainting and falling. The State Department says the concussion is not severe, that the Secretary of State then became dehydrated after suffering from a stomach virus, and that she's going to be working from home. However, all of that is going to keep her from testifying before Congress on Thursday as planned about the deadly September 11th attack on the U.S. consulate in Benghazi, Libya. Joining me now is former State Department Egypt officer Joel Rubin. Joel, it's good to have you here in this long-awaited independent report on the attack that killed U.S. Ambassador Chris Stevens and three others in Benghazi is going to be presented to the State Department today. Secretary Clinton is not going to be there.
Well, Thomas, this is a very important week for the Accountability Review Board. The results are coming out today to the State Department. There'll be an open session later in the week with the two top deputies to Secretary Clinton. It is unfortunate that she's ill, and certainly to have her forcefully communicate the results of the report would be excellent, and she is the best at this, the best that the administration has to offer. But her deputies are very strong, and they'll make the arguments that need to be made.
All right, so the Senate committee is headed by John Kerry, who is expected now to succeed Clinton as Secretary of State, said in her absence on Thursday that it was understandable. However, the Republican chairman on all of this is not so kind, saying that it's unfortunate that she can't testify. This problem with security, though, Joel, at the embassies will not fall in Kerry's lap, so to speak. So will this attack overshadow his confirmation hearings if he is nominated to this role?
This issue has been politicized from the beginning, and the benefit of the Accountability Review Board is to depoliticize it and make sure that our diplomats in the field have the resources they need. And this investigation has moved very swiftly, so it should be kept in that vein. Tom Pickering, who's leading the board, he once was the boss to Chris Stevens, who was killed in Benghazi. This is very personal, and it should be kept at a level where people understand that these diplomats, the review board experts, they're providing the best advice to make sure our diplomats in the field are safe.
Joel Rubin, Joel, thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
And tomorrow, the State Department gets a look at a detailed report about the attack on the consulate in Benghazi, Libya. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton ordered this review. Members of Congress are scheduled to get the classified briefing on Wednesday. Clinton will not testify. She is recovering after a concussion from fainting due to dehydration.
There's one thing Democrats and Republicans can agree on. As of today, Hillary Clinton would be an unstoppable candidate if she runs for president in 2016.
Hillary Clinton.com.